So let's look at one more passage in Hebrews. Okay, let's look at Hebrews 3rd chapter. Okay, Hebrews 3rd chapter. Let's look at Hebrews 3rd chapter, 3rd verse. Okay, let's read that. It says, Jesus has been found worthy of greater honor than Moses, just as the builder of a house has greater honor than the house itself. For every house is built by someone, but God is the builder of everything. Moses was faithful as a servant in all God's house, bearing witness to what would be spoken by God in the future. But Christ is a faithful as a son over God's house, and we are his house if indeed we hold firmly to our confidence and the hope in which we glory. You understand what it's talking? What is it talking? You know, Moses in the Old Testament, he was a slave in God's eyes. He was not son. In the New Testament, Jesus served God as a son. You understand? You follow Moses, you will always feel like a slave of God. You follow Jesus, you will feel like a son of God. Who are you following? Which kind of thinking are you following? Do you feel like, oh, I'm having to do all these things like a donkey? No. You're not a donkey. You're a son. You're a daughter. You're doing what you're doing because you want to bring good name to your Father in heaven. That should motivate you. Amen? So that is something that I want you to take away. Okay, next. Okay, now, coming to Romans 3, which we wanted to refer. Okay, coming back to that, Romans 3, 21 now. Okay, Romans 3, 21. But now, it says, but now, apart from the law, the righteousness of God has been made known, to which the law and the prophets testify. This righteousness is given through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. There is no difference between Jew and Gentile, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And all are justified freely by his grace through the redemption that came by Christ Jesus. God presented him, Christ, as sacrifice, atonement through the shedding of his blood to be received by faith. He did this to demonstrate his righteousness, because in his forbearance he had left the sins committed beforehand unpunished. He did it to demonstrate his righteousness at the present time, so as to be just and the one who justifies those who have faith in Jesus. Do you understand what it's trying to tell you? You know what it's trying to tell you? That we are all mess. Is any of you any good? No one is good, not even one. No one is righteous. No one can. Okay. So when we are all mess, how can we be seen right before God? Why does God look at you being right? You say, I'm not right, I'm guilty, I'm useless. But God looks at you and says, you're wonderful, you're valuable, you're worthy, you're my son. I'm so proud of you. Lord, I can't understand. I'm not proud of myself. No. That is because of his righteousness. You see, the cross, the righteousness of God is credited to you. You are not righteous, but righteousness of God is credited to you. You saw all those small lines below? They're all you. Sinners. We're all sinners below on those lines. But because you have faith, even though you're down, because of he's up, his righteousness to you will make you up and right before God. That's why you need to be not paralyzed by analyzing yourself. Paralysis of analysis. Be confident and assured in God that God forgives you. Okay, you need to discipline your mind and accept forgiveness and grace today and forget yesterday. Make a new beginning. Not to take grace in vain, I'm telling you, but make a fight. God wants you to fight. That's enough for him. Make every effort, he says. Not that you will be perfect, not that you will be righteous, but make effort. But the rest of it, I will fill up. I will fill it up. So that's why you are all good. Don't go away feeling terrible and mess. But bring out the good in you. God wants you to bring out your good, and he wants to make you a worthy vessel. That depends on you fighting it. If you don't fight in your mind, you will be lost. Battle is in the mind. The devil plays on your mind and throws all negatives to you. You need to say, get behind me, devil. I'm a son of God. I'm a more than a conqueror. His grace is sufficient for me. I shall not fear. He is with me. He justifies me. He sanctifies me. He uses me. I am a mess, but I'm a better mess than the whole world of sinners. You need to say that to yourself. I'm a mess, but I'm a forgiven mess. Accept that forgiveness. And then say, I'm a forgiven mess. I'm here to save the rest of the mess. Amen? So that is the way you need to be assured. Okay. See, what if you want to understand what I'm trying to impress on you is a spirit of assurance. So you have that, you know, through faith, you have access into that grace. All that God wants is not your, you know, nothing else he wants for you to stand in his presence. And, you know, only faith, you access that grace. And it gives you peace and it gives you hope. Your hope should be heaven, not this worldly riches or anything like that. So that is what you need to be rooted in. Okay. So having said that, what I want you to know is that, you know, one final passage I want to tell you. I want you to go away with a confidence today that you are special. Okay. Final passage I want to share with you is Hebrews 10. Hebrews 10, let's read 19 onwards. Okay? It says, therefore, brothers and sisters, since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtain, that is his body, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us draw near to God with sincere heart and with full assurance that faith brings, having our hearts sprinkled to cleanse us from a guilty conscience and having our bodies washed with pure water. Can you imagine those words? It says confidence, assurance, cleanse, you know, a living way. All right. And, that's what you need to make your heart. Today, I want you to feel assured and encouraged that you are special. You're worthy. You're an instrument of God. But in this same passage, it says, be sincere. Don't be insincere to God. Okay? Don't be insincere to God. That's my appeal to you. God loves you. He's sincere. He keeps his promises. You have, you know, made a promise to him on the day of, you know, baptism. I live by my good conscience, O Lord. But don't go back on your, don't throw in the towel. Fight the good fight. In your generation, it's much more wicked than my generation. It's getting worse. Your challenges are much more hard. We understand. But if you don't even make a fight, that is, you take one step to God, God will take 100 steps towards you. Okay, so that is something that I want you to know. Okay, and not only that, he has not left you without, without giving power. Can we show one more slide? Next. Slides? Yeah. Next, go ahead. Yeah. So, he has not left you alone. He says, I'm not going to leave you alone as orphans. Okay. So, I'm not going to leave you alone orphans. All right. And he has given you the Holy Spirit. Okay. He has given you the Holy Spirit. He lives in you. You are the temple of God. If you are led by the Holy Spirit, he is with you. He will lead you. He will make you victorious. He will make you more than conquerors. Don't feel defeated. Don't throw in the towel. Don't give up the fight. Don't give up the faith. Okay? Make every effort. Okay? And be led by the Holy Spirit. So that is next. Yeah. And the Holy Spirit, you know, there are two sides in our heart. You know, the good conscience and the sinful nature. They're at a battle. Okay, they're at a battle. But God has given you power to the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit that lives in you empowers your conscience. and makes your fight, you know, you're able. Sometimes you feel like I'm not able. You don't believe you can overcome. Some of you have given up. Say, I can't overcome, bro. I'm addicted to this. No, you can. You're undermining the power of God. God can do immeasurably more than what you think and imagine. Try. Don't throw in the towel. Make an effort. Make an effort. Take one step. He will take you 100 steps. His power is in you. Even if you are powerless, he is more powerful. You need to make a decision. I'm going to fight. I'm going to go back and fight my struggles and bring honor to him. Okay. And Holy Spirit carries your prayers. Sometimes you say, I don't know what to pray for. But Holy Spirit carries your prayers. And he grieves when you do wrong. Okay, so that is something that I want. What I am trying to tell you, you be anchored in God. You be anchored in your true value in God. You find yourself worthy and valuable as stars in the sky, as sons and daughters of him, to bring destined to bring good name to him. That's how you find value in him. Put your life in his hand. You know, just like we have seen so many stories of life change, many people's life will change when you resolve to do something for God. So that is my appeal to you. Okay, so what is something that you need to take away? You need to take away that I'm going to not, you know, there is an illustration I want to use. You know, you can have a relationship with God like this, you know, like this. That means God and you. Or you can try to find relationships between each other. You understood? This is man to man relationship. We are seeking encouragement from each other, but there is no God in it. Okay? But the true relationship is like this. Okay? Not only God, me. Not only man, I seek encouragement. But each other and God. This kind of relationships you establish in your church. Practically, I want to debut. How you should go back? Go back to, you know, the same passage is spur one another on to love and good deeds. Meet together. This is the foundation of our church. Meet together, spur one another. And some of us are saying, you know, oh, my leader is not organizing meetings, my leader is not organizing fun times. Are every time leader, koi aayega, bachega, koi nahi aayega, khud ko bacha lo. You know, you need to stop analyzing and, you know, there is a song, you know, like, you know. You go back and make plans. Make plans for your own self, you know, connect, create WhatsApp group. You meeting together is a meeting. You know, only if a leader organizes a meeting is a meeting. That's a wrong thinking. That's a wrong thinking. Why can't you meet each other? Encourage one another and edify one another. Not for dates, by the way. Don't do that, okay? All right, don't use my name for that. Encourage one another. Okay, encourage one another, boys, girls, you know, fellowship, you know, create some fun times, fam. You know, why only AICC has to be a great fellowship gathering? You know, many years back we used to say swamp camp, great gathering, you know, I got convicted. I said, why only one more year we have to wait? We can have swamp camp in Hyderabad every month. Every month. And I want you to tell you, for 1 year, every month, all of our teens are here. Every month we have swamp camp in our house. Boys, 10 boys, 10 girls, 2 flats. We have fun, fellowship, food. They don't sleep, they hang out. There are witnesses here. Many of them made it here. We had swamp camp every month. Why can't you have camps in your own cities? Why you have to wait for AICC? It's because all the time you're looking for somebody to do something. You're a young generation. Youth in your age are doing so many great things. Shaking the world. That girl in, you know, kind of German girl in about environment, he's shaking the presidents of the country. She's hardly half your age. She's not even of your age. Even the presidents are trembling about her. She's fighting the environmental cause. You have so much power in you. So much talent in you. Bring it out and make a difference. Thank you.